Hello everyone. In this video, we study about inverse Laplace transform by computing the square method. Consider a function of the form. F of s equal to this pi of s by this p times s square plus q times s plus r, where this quadratic equation in the denominator cannot be factorized to get a real roots. Suppose if I want to find inverse transformation for such kind of functions, the very first step is I have to express the quadratic equation p times s square plus q times s plus r in the form of is s minus a whole squared plus b squared. So this is the first step. And in the second step, what we do, we express pi of s. Express the function pi of s in the denominator as a function of s minus a. So what it becomes now, the denominator is also a function of s minus a and numerator is also a function of s minus a. So we get capital F of s to be a function, some other function, I call it as g of s minus a. Now what we do, we take inverse now. Now we take inverse transformation on both sides. Inverse Laplace transformation on both sides. And using the known standard forms, we find out the inverse transformation for capital F of s. Now, we just saw one example and method of computing the square. Suppose if we take an example like example one. Suppose find L inverse of s plus 5 divided by s square minus 6s plus 13. By looking at the denominator equation, we can say that the denominator cannot be factorized to get a real roots. So the very first step is I have to express this denominator as a function of s minus a. So now I consider the denominator now. Consider s square minus 6s plus 13. So I can write this as a square plus 2ab, it is 2 times 3 into s plus b square. The value of b will be 9, sorry. The value of b will be 3, 3 square is 9. So 9 plus 4 will be 13. So I'm expressing this as 2 into 3 into s plus 9 plus 4. So I can write this as it is a plus b whole squared plus 4 can be written as 2 square. So the denominator I express in terms of s minus a. Same way, now I consider s plus 5. Consider s plus 5. But this s plus 5 can be written as s plus 3 plus 2. So we express the denominator in terms of s plus 3, numerator in terms of s plus 3. So this implies the inverse transformation of s plus 5 divided by s square minus 6s plus 13 can be written as this inverse transformation of s plus 5 will become s plus 3 of plus 2 divided by the denominator can be written as s plus 3 whole squared plus 2 square. Now I separate this fraction and I apply the inverse transformation. So what we get here, I can rewrite this RHS as L inverse of s plus 3 by s plus 3 whole squared plus 2 square plus L inverse of it is 2 by s plus 3 whole squared plus 2 square. Now this resembles, this both terms resembles the standard form of inverse Laplace transformation. So now I can write this as inverse transformation of s plus 5 by s square minus 6s plus 13 will be equal to, it is of the form s by s square plus a square. So the inverse transformation is cos at, cos 2 times t. Since s is replaced by s plus 3, I need to pre-multiply the function with e to the power of minus 3 times t. Again plus, here also same thing, a by a square plus b square form. It is sin at is the inverse transformation. Since s is replaced by s minus of minus 3, it is e to the power of minus 3t. So this is the required inverse Laplace transformation for the given function by using the method of computing the square. In the next session, we will solve some more problems. Thank you all.